What is going on YouTube? Carlo here. Welcome to the vlog. This is the channel, guys, where we talk about sneakers, life, and tech. And for this episode, we're going to talk about 5 sneakerhead must-have items. Let's go! To the channel yet, please make sure that you do so, because I've teamed up with Sneaker Talk Christian to actually give away 2 Bapes the Sneakers. All you guys have to do, subscribe to my channel, subscribe to his channel, follow me on Instagram, follow him on Instagram, and then click the link down below to see the rest of Christian's mechanics. The winner will be drawn on June 26, so good luck. Before we get to the 5 sneakerhead must-haves, I just want to share with you guys and do a quick Gachapon unboxing. Actually, you have 4 boxes over here for the Avengers. Well, I don't know what they're called. Mystery Minis Bubbleheads. So you see here, you don't know what's inside. You buy it and you get a random bubblehead. Now, here are the characters that you guys can get. So you have Iron Man, Captain America, Hulk, Thor, etc., etc. Now, I have 2 characters that I really want to get from this Gachapon set. I want to get Thor, and I also want to get Thanos. Now, if I get Iron Man, that's a nice bonus, but my main 2 priorities are Thor and Thanos. So let's unbox each of the boxes and see maybe if I get lucky or if I don't. So let's take a look at the first one first. By the way, I got all of these boxes over at Toy Kingdom here in the Philippines. And yeah, they cost like almost 500 pesos each. So kind of pricey, right? For a bubblehead. So let's take a look at the first one. Whoa! Okay, so the bad news was the figure literally flew out of my hand. But the good news is I actually got the first character that I really wanted to get. We have Thor, the God of Thunder. So we have Stormbreaker, that new axe hammer that he was able to get. And you have that, I think, time travel suit, quantum suit, or whatever you want to call it. That he's actually wearing, which he also wore during the Avengers Endgame movie. So 1 out of 2. So if we get Thanos, 2 out of 2, that would be really awesome. So I hope the figure doesn't fly out with this particular box, because it's actually kind of hard to unbox. So there you go. Next up, we have Rocket. So we kind of took a miss there, but hey, at least it still looks cute. Thanos, Gachapon gods, please be kind. We have another Thor. So we have 2 Thor bubbleheads now. So Iron Man, Thanos or Iron Man? Come on, come on, come on. Thanos or Iron Man? Hoping for the best, guys. Hope with me. Let's see if I'm lucky this time around. Whoa! I'm okay with it. It's a nice consolation. We have a very happy, perky Steve Rogers, aka Captain America. Hey, we got 1 out of 2. Good enough. So now let's get to the top 5 items that any sneakerhead, I think, should have or would want to have in his, I don't know, everyday arsenal. First up, you need to have dope socks. And when it comes to socks, I love 2 brands in particular. First one, let's go local. This is one of my favorite local sock brands. They're called Proppy. So Proppy comes up with a lot of really nice printed socks, from dinosaurs to ninjas to Filipino things such as jeepneys and even like isaw and fish balls, to different kinds of socks, from no-show socks to longer length socks and a wide range of socks. When it comes to international, I absolutely love Stan's socks, especially their Star Wars collection. They just look incredibly sick. This one is one of my favorite socks from them. This is the Darth Vader long length. I don't know what you call them, but yeah, they're really nice performance socks. I love the fit. I love the comfort. I love the breathability. Excellent quality socks, again, from Stan's. Only problem with them is they're kind of pricey. Each pair of socks costs like over 1,000 pesos, which is kind of crazy if you ask me. But hey, if you have the budget, if you want to invest in good socks, check them out, Stan's. Another thing that a sneakerhead or any sneakerhead would probably want to have in his particular arsenal would be a nice sneaker bag. Now, there are a big selection of sneaker bags available out there today, from the pricey ones, from private label, which sell anywhere from like 10,000 to 14,000 pesos. But there are also local brand options. This is a new local brand that's actually coming out, or that's actually launching today, or I think they just launched recently. This is from the brand called Valve. I don't know if I pronounced that properly. If I didn't, forgive me. So this one is a sneaker duffel bag. Actually has a lot of, I don't know what you call, Porter vibes, because you have the black and the orange stripe over here at the bottom. You have pockets here on either side of the external part. And what I love about this particular bag is they actually reinforce the sides so it doesn't easily deform, which is one of the problems with a lot of sneaker bags out there. So if you open it, here are some of the bonuses that you guys will get. You have that really nice orange pop of color inside. You have the branding over here, and it comes with 4 dust bags already. So you can put your individual sneakers inside the dust bags. And the great thing about that is you actually get to keep the interior clean, because if your shoes get dirty, the tendency is you stain the insides of the actual duffel bag. So the compartments are actually also removable, so you can change it and customize it depending. I'm really having a bad hair day, bad hair day. But anyway, you can change it depending on what you guys want. If you want it as an overnight bag to put in like clothes or slippers or electronics, you can do that. There's even like a slot here for your laptop. Also comes with a really nice keychain, which I won't bother to take out. So yeah, check it out. I'll put the link down below to their Instagram account. Again, that's the next must-have item, a nice sneaker bag. Of course, you need sneaker cleaning products. And when it comes to sneaker cleaning products, I'm really appreciative that Crep Protect actually sends us a ton of stuff. And I'm actually, that's a great thing, because I've been buying their products before. I love the quality of their products, and they have like a wide variety of products that you guys can pick from for any like reason. So if, let's say, you have like a suede sneaker, you can use their suede eraser to be able to properly clean it and remove stains. If you need like, I don't know, if your sneakers are starting to get mold, which I hope they don't, or if you have like grailed sneakers and you want them properly protected, my advice, get Crep Pills. They dehumidify, deodorize the sneakers, especially the ones that you consider your favorites or your grails. My favorite product of them of all time are the Crep Wipes. I don't actually have the patience to properly clean it myself, all the sneakers. My impatient way of cleaning my sneakers regularly is through Crep Wipes. If you guys are patient, if you want to use the cleaning solution, you can actually get their cleaning solution to be able to properly deep clean your sneakers. Now, the great thing about cleaning it yourself is, number one, you don't have to spend on sending it to a cleaning shop, which is usually more expensive. Obviously, with one bottle of Crep Cure, you can probably clean your sneakers more than your typical sneaker shop. And secondly, you don't have to wait so long before it comes back to you. So that's item number 3, I think, on my list. Crep products, or cleaning products in general, for your sneakers. Number 4 is something that would look really nice on your table, or on your desk, in your CR. You might want to invest in sneaker books. So what are sneaker books? This is actually a gift from Mary Bautista, a local tech YouTuber here in the Philippines. Check out our collab. The link can be found down below. This book says 1,000 Sneakers, a guide to the world's greatest kicks from sport to street universe. We have different brands of sneakers and nice photos. You have the Lecoq Sportif. You have the Adidas Americana High, Air Maxes. The great thing about books like this one is that apart from it being a nice decorative piece in your house, you actually get to read about the history of the shoes, the design think behind the shoes, the inspiration behind the sneakers, which allows you to actually appreciate your sneakers even more. If you can't afford to buy new shoes all the time, another great thing to do to be able to love your shoes even more is to research about the story behind your sneakers. So that's the 4th item in our sneaker must-have list, books about sneakers. Number 5, this is again more for your sneakers, which you consider your grails, are crates or sneaker cases. Those are the boxes that you guys see over there at the back. The brand that I use, as probably you guys probably would have guessed, are Crep Crates. But there are other more affordable boxes that you can use to be able to properly store and protect and take care of your sneakers. Now, it might get expensive if you buy boxes for all of your shoes. You don't have to do that. You actually just probably would want to invest in boxes for the sneakers that you consider your favorites, you consider your grails, you consider the ones that have the most value, and you want to give them the best protection that you can afford. And that's the reason why you would want to buy like sneaker boxes. But hey, if you can afford to buy a lot, they look actually really nice if you stack them up like how I do them in my back, over there at my back. So that's the fifth item, sneaker boxes. So those are my top 5 sneakerhead must-haves. What's your favorite of the list? Let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear from you guys. Also, if there's something that you feel that a sneakerhead should have that's not in my list, please do comment it so we can add it to my next list, which will be probably like a few months from now. Off top of the top of my head, other items that sneakerheads probably would want to have are like really nice tapered pants that allow for them to show off their sneakers, or really nice caps that go well with, I don't know, like the hype look, or probably like more muted clothes to be able to allow them, again, to shift the focus and attention to the shoes that they are wearing. By the way, if you guys want to buy great locally made sneaker pants, check out Above the Ankle. Excellent quality, great products that they have. And for our power up words of wisdom for the day, I want to keep it basic. I want to keep it something that a lot of you kids, especially men or boys watching this channel, can learn something from me. The Tito Carlo in me wants to teach you guys a lesson. Now, here's one thing that a lot of guys forget. Handkerchiefs, or those are like the pieces of cloth that you're supposed to keep with you, aren't just for you. One of the best ways to be able to impress a lady or to impress a girl is to always have like a clean handkerchief inside your pocket. So one of the things that I was taught when I was young, especially by my dad, was to always carry two handkerchiefs with me. One was for me, that when I would sneeze or when I'm like sweaty and stuff, but I would always have like a clean one that I would have, that I could offer to either a lady friend or to, well, now to my wife, or maybe for you guys, to your girlfriend. So if you want to impress a lady, a very basic tip, have a clean handkerchief always ready and don't be afraid to offer it. And well, you won't be afraid to offer it, you won't be ashamed to offer it because it's clean. And with those words of wisdom from Tito Carlo, I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Please don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to join the Bapes the giveaway that I'm doing with Christian. And by the way, I'm also giving away 4 1,000 peso gadget mystery boxes. The link to that giveaway can be found down below. That's it for now, guys. Peace. God bless. What's up? Boom.